with their family near. While our talent from Cullina will bring you good cheer.
A long time ago in Bethlehem, a special story I must tell about a baby called Jesus. Behind me we have a picture of all the people in this special story. We will break the magical Christmas and make these people come to life. Meet the angel.
I am Angel Gabriel. I told Mary she will be blessed with a baby boy. We will name the baby Jesus. We must let everyone around the world know. There has been a new baby boy.
Along with us, we have our innkeepers.
But Mary and Joseph could find no room in the air.
No one in the house except for their minding their sheep.
I heard the angels sing. What did they sing?
A baby has been born in a stable. The stars will meet.
Meet the drummer boy with his drum.
We'll beat my drum to celebrate your new king.
Look at the sparkles on my three wise men.
Follow the shining star.
The star will lead to our new king.
We must bring gifts to the new baby.
Last we have Mary and Joseph with their baby Jesus.
Our baby has arrived in a stable.
Is that everybody knows this every time you came.
Till morning is night. Once upon a time, a long, long time ago, begins the story of a baby that most of you should know.
His daddy's name was Joseph, and Mary was his mom. This babe was very special. He was God's only son. Some angels came from heaven, and they began to sing to the shepherds in the fields below. Glad tidings do we bring.
A bright star lit the heaven to light the Magi's way to the baby in the manger who was born on Christmas Day.
And all who gathered round him rejoiced and praised with birth. For the baby King of Jesus is our Savior here on earth.
What kind of photos do eggs take? Elfies.
Why are Christmas trees so bad at sewing?
Because they always drop their needles.
Where do humans go down to?
At a snowball.
What do you call a green elf?
Elfish.
Where does someone keep their money? In a snowbank.
What does an elf learn in school? Alphabet.
What do snowmen like for breakfast? Frosted Flakes.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Rain.
Rain who?
Reindeer.
Why wouldn't the Christmas tree stand up? Because it had no legs.
What happens when you eat Christmas decorations? You get tinselitis.
But why does snowman talk to other snowmen? You smell like carrots.
What do you get when you cross a snowman with a vampire? Frostbite.
How does Rudolph know when Christmas is coming? He checks his calendar.
Hey Reese, what? Wait, you can't know, snowman.
What?
Why?
I got one for you.
What?
What? Who delivers presents to baby sharks?
What?
Santa Jaws.
Hey, what's an elf's kind of fairy music?
What?
Rap music.
Merry Christmas,
Merry
everyone.
Christmas, everyone.
Mistletoe hung where you can see every couple tries to
Merry Christmas! Finding my woods on a snowy evening by Robert Frost. Whose woods these are, I think I know. His house is in the village, though. You will not see me stopping here to watch you close the melt the snow. My little horse must think it queer to stop without a farmhouse near. Between the woods and frozen lake, the daggers seem to all be here.
He uses his hammer and spell to shake, to ask if there is no mistake. The only other sounds a sweep of easy wind and down the creek.
The woods are lovely down the deep, but I have promises to keep. And miles to go before I sleep, and miles to go before I sleep.
A chubby little snowman had a carrot nose. Along came a bunny, and what do you suppose? The hungry little bunny, looking for some lunch, grabbed a snowman's nose, nibble, nibble, crunch.
Thank you. For all your Christmas presents, I thank you one and all. For the big ones, many thanks, and a few of them small.
The funniest face, looked down at me from a silver ball on a Christmas tree. At first I thought it was Santa's elf, but I looked again and it was just myself.
The day before Christmas, we've been helping with the cake and licking out the pan, and wrapping up our packages as neatly as we can. We've hung our stockings up beside the open grate, and now there's nothing more to do except to wait.
That
button
stinks. I took a lick of a peppermint stick, and oh, it tasted yummy. It used to be on the Christmas tree, but now it's in my tummy.
The first snowflake
fell today, and with any luck, more will follow. Billions and trillions of snowflakes would mean they'd have to cancel school tomorrow.
The night before Christmas!
Shh!
'Twas the night before Christmas, when all through the house, not a creature was stirring,
not even a mouse.
The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in the hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds, on visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief, I in my cap, had just said,
as I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound.
He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and dust.
A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his sack.
He spoke not a word, and went straight to his work, and filled all the stockings and turned the creature.
Made his fingers
right in
his nose
and giving
the
nose
up their chimney.
He sprang to his head, to the tree and gave a whistle. And made it all through.
But I heard him exclaim as he drove outside,
"Happy Christmas to all and to all in the night." Nothing but
you all enjoyed our first ever virtual Christmas show. Like many of you, my favourite time of the year is Christmas, and I love watching the movie The Elf. And my favourite line is when Buddy the Elf says, "The best way to spread Christmas cheer is to sing out loud for all to hear." So I hope when you watch back over this YouTube video, you will sing along with our backing tracks and spread lots of Christmas cheer in your family homes. I was delighted that Miss Cullina came with the idea of having a virtual Christmas show. She put together a committee and was ably assisted by Mrs. Murphy and Mike Coffey. And her vision was made a reality because of one person. We owe a huge thank you to our SNA here, Thomas Straka. Thomas is a well-known local videographer, and he has spent countless hours recording and editing this production. but I think he will agree he has done a very fine job. Thank you so much, Thomas. And while on the topic of thank yous, there are a few other people I need to thank. First of all, I need to thank our boys and girls of Cullina National School. I want to congratulate you on your brilliant productions, and I want to thank you for the way you have adapted and accepted our changed environment. You are a positive example to us all. I want to thank the teachers, the SNAs, the bus escorts, and the two people that I consider to be the beating heart of Cullina, Mike Coffey and Agnes Kern. Each one of them has continued to carry out their professional duties, but with so many restrictions in place, it is a difficult thing to do. Yet each morning they come in with a wonderful, positive, can-do attitude, and they have come up with ways around things to make sure that they provide a brilliant service to your children. I want everybody to know how thankful I am to all the staff in Cullina. I want to thank the Parents Association under Fergus Fulan and Paul O'Regan, and the parent body in general for the incredible support you have given to all this year. I want to thank the management and the staff, Mrs. Murphy, Mrs. McLaughlin, and Ms. Doyle, who's currently on maternity leave. And I want to thank especially the Board of Management under the esteemed chairmanship of Paul Neary. The Board of Management are a group of volunteers who have the onerous task of leading a school community. And particularly in the last few months, this has been a very challenging task, but they have done a superb job, and I'm very, very grateful to the Board of Management. I want to say a special hello to Father Fergal and to Peggy. We are all missing our Christmas Mass here, but next year we'll be back bigger and stronger for our Christmas Mass of 2021. But Father Fergal and Peggy, I just want you to know that we're all thinking of you, and we miss your company, but we look forward to seeing you again in the new year. While speaking of Christmas, I would like to share with you what I think is the Christmas message. Since the first Christmas in Bethlehem, right up to today, I feel Christmas is all about love, hope, and family. And maybe in recent years, Christmas has become more commercialized. And maybe in recent years, we have worried so much about presents and buying gifts more than so than the message itself of hope, love, and family. Who would have thought this time last year when we heard in the news about a virus in Wuhan? Who would have known or thought of the monumental impact that virus was going to have on our daily lives? So this year, I think we have a better understanding of the Christmas message. Because when we went into lockdown in March, we didn't miss the shops, we didn't miss the restaurants, we missed our family. We missed seeing our family, and we missed hugging our family. So this Christmas, I think we have a far better understanding of that message of love, hope, and family. So I hope you enjoy spending that precious time this Christmas with your family. You may have to stick to virtual hugs for a little bit longer, but enjoy their company, enjoy their conversation. And together as a family and as a school community, we look forward to 2021 with hope of better days ahead. I want to finish up by sharing with you my favorite Christmas verse. A little child, a shining star, a simple stable with the door ajar. Yet in that place, so bare and forlorn, the hope of all the world was born. I wish your family a very happy Christmas and a very healthy new year. Slán agus beannacht.